Hi everyone, this is Dikshit. Welcome to my channel. In this particular video, I'll be showing how to create a simple Helm chart. And also I'll just walk you through all the files which will be created in that particular step. And then I'll deploy that particular Helm chart onto your Kubernetes cluster. Then we will try to access that particular application from the browser. Okay. So to create a Helm chart, so it's very easy actually. So if you want to have a basic Helm chart structure, what you need to do is like Helm create, and then you need to give the name of your charts. That's all. Okay. So in my case, I'll just provide as my charts. So what it will do, it will create a folder named my chart. Okay. So this I've already copied to my local. It's already there in my local. So because I guess like if I want to show it in here, so it is basically a VA. So that's the reason I've already downloaded that onto my Windows system. So I'm using a Visual Code Studio. So by which I can easily explain it. Okay. So that's the reason I'm just picking that folder here. Okay. So now, so as you can see in this Helm chart, so we have basically templates folder, and we have .helmignore and charts.yml, and then we have values.yml also. So templates directory is very important. So in this only we'll have all the YML files related to our particular Kubernetes. Basically, a Kubernetes objects will be there. As you can see, deployment.yml is there. HPA, horizontal pod autoscaler is there. Ingress, service.yml and service account.yml. Okay, and also other folders like we have a test folder, as you can see. And so why this test folder is very important, like let's say something like you're doing some application, okay, which depends on other application which has to be run before this application runs. So in that scenario, so this test folder will be a very handy. So before running your this Helm charts, so it'll run this YAML. Okay, so it'll try to run this one. If it is successful, then only it'll be your application will be deployed onto your Kubernetes cluster. Okay, if this fails, if it is other than like 200 code or its exit status is like non-zero, so then your charts will gonna fail. Okay, so in you can take scenarios like wherein you want to verify the passwords, username, password, so wherein you want to interact with some service. So before doing the actual deployment on Kubernetes cluster, you wanted to verify that thing and all. So you can achieve it by this one. Okay. And one more mandatory thing. So for this to work, the mandatory thing is like you need to use this annotations. So you need to use helm.sh hook, and then you need to specify whatever you need. Okay. So once this is successful, so in my case, it's basically a dummy thing. So I'm just using a busy box, and I'm doing a wget and chart name and the values, the service port, that's all. Okay. So, but in when you're doing actual application deployment, so sometimes, so as I mentioned, like passwords verification, or if you want to trigger, if you want to hit any services, so that has to be run before this particular one. So those kind of things you can do it. Like it's kind of in Git, if you compare it with Git, so it is kind of a pre-trigger, okay, pre-hook, sorry, pre-hook. So it will check before you commit, right? So that is how it works here. Like before deploying actual thing onto your Kubernetes cluster, so it is like kind of a testing. Okay. And the next one is there is something called as _helpers.tmpl. So this is basically kind of a place wherein we will write functions basically. Okay. So let's say you have so in all the YMLs, like so we will have something called as metadata, right? So in metadata, basically we'll have labels, correct? So if YMLs, many YMLs are related to same application, then so it'll be obviously it'll have same labels, right? So in my case, there are 5 YMLs. If I repeat the code five times, so then it's kind of a repeated, and also like, say, let's say someone, your manager comes and if he says, so let's change some labels in your, metadata of all the YMLs, then you need to update in 5 places, right? So rather than that, what you can do, you can write a function in _helpers.tmpl. As you can see, so I've used my chart labels. So under that, I've defined something. Okay. So whenever I need it in my YML, so I can just call it, as you can see here. So let me go to, yeah, so my chart labels, as you can see under the labels. So I'm just giving my chart dot labels. Okay, don't worry about this one. So I'll discuss all these things in my future videos. So wherein like I'll in detail, I'll discuss about this one. So I just wanted to make this video and brief about each file. And then then in my next videos, I'll be discussing about commands, Helm commands, and also the functions that I've used inside my YML files. Okay. So as you can see, I've used here. Okay. In HPA also, as you can see, I've used my dot labels. So that like whatever the repeated code. So I've just used my underscore helpers.tmpl. So I've moved all the common things, common labels here. And then whenever I need, I can call it by with this name. Okay. So that is the importance of underscore helpers.tmpl. And so, yeah. So, I mean, which basically reduces, duplicated code, duplicated lines in your YMLs. Okay. And one more thing. So other YML files, as you can see, these are so Kubernetes YML files, basically. But I'll tell you like why we have these things and all include with. So values.yml, there are many things I'll discuss about in my upcoming videos. Okay. And the next one is notes.txt. So this file will be, basically it will be displayed when you lint a YML or when you deploy this particular chart onto your Kubernetes cluster. So that time this particular output will be seen on our console. Okay. So once we deploy, right, so you'll be able to see that this particular output. I'll show you that. Okay. And the next file is now the template folder. So as we discussed, so it will be having YML files, basically Kubernetes related YML files. Okay. The next one is dot helm ignore. So this is a kind of like, it is similar to a Docker ignore or a Git ignore. So whatever the files you don't want to consider for helm commands, then you can specify those files here. Okay. So then the next one is chart.yml. So this is basically contains metadata about your chart. So what is your chart name? You're giving a description about your chart, and then you're telling the type of application and the version you're using and the app version you're using. So when you do some changes and if you want to deploy it again, so it should be like incremented, like it's kind of a different version. Okay. So it will be stored in your release information. That's the reason. So whenever you deploy, so it's better. It is recommended, as you can see. So this is basically I've created by using Helm command, right? So they have specified there, as you can see, this is the version number, the application being deployed. So this version number should be incremented for each time when you do some changes. Okay. So these are all the best practices. So you need to change, like when you're changing some configuration, so then you need to update this version also. Okay. So then the next one is values.yml. So the main, this is also one of the main file. So when rendering happens, like when charts manifest will be created, right? See, when you supply these things to Kubernetes YML, so Kubernetes cluster, so these things will not be understood, right? So it has to be replaced with our actual values. As you can see, one simple example. So image is there. If you supply like this, the Kubernetes cluster won't understand, right? So you need to render it and properly, and then you should send it to cluster. Correct. So all these values, like whatever, see, if you see here, so let me open another window. Okay. So as you can see here, this is values.yml. So let me open my deployment.yml. As you can see, so this is image value I'm using. So values.image.repository. Here under value, this is values fold file. In that, it will search for image tag under that repository. So the nginx will be replaced here. So why this we are doing is like if the value is changing continuously, if the value is like not static, it'll gonna change for every time. So then it is a better candidate to be present in values.yml. So rather than going to your YML files and searching in your YML files, what you can do, you can place it in values.yml and you can refer it in your deployment files. Okay. And also, so as this is a simple one, so we don't have much values.yml, but if your application is growing complex, then you'll have a couple of tags that will be used in multiple YMLs. In that case, so if you want to change one thing, so you need to update many files. Rather than that, like you can place that one in values.yml and you can refer it like this, like values.security context. Like this, you can refer it. Okay, so it is basically Helm will render these values before sending you to cluster. Okay, so now so we have this particular Helm chat. So then what we can do is like best practices, like before deploying onto Kubernetes cluster. So what you can do, there is a command called as Helm lint, and you can supply your charts directory. So when you do this one, so as you can see, if all the syntax and everything is fine, so it says like one charts is linted and zero charts has been failed. Okay. So if any mistake is there, then it will gonna fail. Okay. So it is always better before deploying onto Kubernetes cluster, it is better to lint first and then. Okay. So and one more thing, so if you want to see before deploying onto your cluster, you want to see what my YML files look exactly. So then the command is helm install. Then you need to give -- dry run. And then you need to give -- debug. Then specify your charts folder. Okay. Okay. Like in Helm 3. So in Helm 2, what used to happen, like if you don't provide any name, so it used to auto-generate it. But in Helm 3, so what they did is like, you need to specify the name. Okay. If you don't specify, there is something option, -- generate -name. So if you wish like I need, let it be a random name, then you can use that option and you can run your command. Okay. So when I do this, as you can see now, so our Helm has rendered our YML files. So this is how it looks like. Okay. Still my application has been not installed. Okay. So it's just like I've did like, I just wanted to check how my YML looks like. So this is the command you can use and you can see. So what are all the values will be replaced. Okay. So this is how it looks like. Now what we will do is we will deploy. We'll execute the actual command to deploy our cluster. We'll deploy our Helm charts onto Kubernetes cluster. Okay. So now, as you can see, now I have my charts, and now we will do the actual deployment onto Kubernetes cluster. Okay. So now what we can do, Helm. Then you can do Helm install. Then you need to specify the name. Let me specify it as example. And then let me give my charts folder. And also I wanted to use this particular service. Like I need to access this particular pod, whatever I'm creating through Helm, from my browser, right? So in that case, my service port should set to node port, correct? As you can see here, we have the output, right? So as you can see here, in my service, so basically it is set to cluster IP. Okay. So if I want to change on by using like command, so then there is something called as -- set, and then it is service, right? Service dot type is equals to say as node port. Okay. So now, as you can see, so I showed you like whatever there in that this particular .txt was there, na notes.txt. So as you can see now, it is like displayed. Okay. Now let's go ahead and let's list our Helm release. So whether it has been created successfully or not, Helm list. So yeah, it has been created. And now we can verify kubectl get all also. So now if we see. Let me zoom out. So as you can see, so it has been created. Replica set has been created. Deployment has been created. As you can see, service has been created. So the node port for this one is like 31993. Okay. And I need to get my node IP also. So let me go to my GCP and get the node IP. So GCP login. This is my GCP account. So basically I have only one node. So this will be my IP, and then basically I'm deploying Nginx, Nginx. So that's the reason I'm getting Nginx welcome app. Okay. So this is how, so as you can see, so this is very easy to manage your Kubernetes files, right? So this is the, like, simple Helm charts. So when you in a production level cases, or like if you want to work with any application, so you might create multiple YMLs, right? To manage those things, like, it's very difficult. So that's the reason if you use Helm, so it is very easy to maintain multiple YML files which are related to Kubernetes. Okay. And then, like, if you uninstall that particular release, so what you need to do is, like, basically first you do Helm list, and then you can do Helm uninstall, and then give the name of this particular one. In my case, it's an example. I can just click OK now. So once this is done, so you won't be able to, the deployment, everything related to this one will be deleted. Okay. So now see, you're not able to do this. And if you do Helm list also, this won't be visible. Yeah. So that's all for the video. So I just wanted to show a basic Helm chart. So if you like the video, please share and subscribe. Thank you. In the next video, I'll be just discussing about Helm commands. Thank you.